Security. Decentralized administration. Oh.
Have victims have passion but no courage? Have babies all have a favorite saying and adage that all we want to do is manage? I was 21 years of age when I realized my mind was locked up in a cage. I lived in a small town, much less a village. There I learned that ignorance could be a savage. It's a new chapter in my life, but one with knowledge. And I boldly hold a pen while I write this new page. For as I stand before the world, taking the stage, my life must carry this one message. Listen closely, you might not learn this in college. This is spiritually discerned, reverential knowledge. That if God gives you a dream, a mental image, it is possible if you believe and dare to engage. Life is more perceptive than just actual knowledge. This place will be a reality if you dare to acknowledge that despite your circumstance, your dreams are not garbage. And as I speak, they are fire burn like a holy outrage.
Oh, yes.
Give me an ego, I will be an ostrich. Cause you can't fly putting excuses like a horse pulls the cabbage. You may be young, but that's no disadvantage. You will learn and grow at every new stage. You are stronger and braver than you were meant to believe in college. God lives in you, it's another kind of courage. So don't let failures get you discouraged. Cause failures have tons of experience and knowledge in storage. What looks like a blockage is not really a blockage. It's an opportunity to gain experiential knowledge, to grow in wisdom and learn a new message, which you will later use to inspire and encourage. My life is a book God offers with this message. That if God gives you a dream, get wisdom, mount your courage. So if you fail over and over and the world calls you garbage, remember that failures are better than average. This knowledge is the type of knowledge that the average will never acknowledge because they have no mental image and thus lack the courage to engage. But be encouraged. Refuse to be average. Remember that success is failures without a loss of courage. So while the average stay caged in their cottage, choose to take the stage and refuse to manage. Jongo Hub has decided to put Mandela's image in their office space so that people can constantly draw inspiration from me. I don't see you clapping. What's the problem? I'm taking through the slap. Alright, so listen, with the spirit of Mandela, I'm going to be doing fear. Fear, the first fear being the ground, the second fear being the ground, it's by saying be afraid of fear. And when I see Mandela says, I don't care if I die, it means that this is a guy who feared fear. Alright? So can I do it? It's 4 minutes long. Listen and be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There is nothing to fear but fear itself. Who is fear anyway? He's a pessimist who imagines the worst to scare you out of taking a new step. A thought that gives you every great reason not to try. An instinct that shuts your mouth on trying to speak. The perfect ally to doubt, unbelief, and hesitation. An architect that draws a world of impossibility and mediocrity around the person. Fear is a spirit that drowns faith, quenches passion, clouds visions, darkens futures, strangles destinies, and kills dreams. Fear is a prison that keeps you locked into your comfort zone, stopping you from exploring the new, fetching the possibilities outside, and fulfilling your dreams. I learned early enough that the trouble has caused the of fear and the attitude of going ahead in its presence. Feel the fear and do it anyway. Never let it get in your way. You are stronger and wiser than people say. You become better and better every day. Today is a new day. I don't care what happened yesterday. Maybe you failed from Monday to Sunday, but get ready, it's time to rise again. You can't just be defeated and say, make up your mind to start again, stay again, write again, train again, and hey, whatever you do, never forget to pray. Fear clouds our perception of the truth of things and produces in our minds a false reality. Fear. F-E-A-R. Falsified evidence appearing real. False experience affecting reason. Frequent exaggeration altering reality. Fictitious expectations and disputing real. Fruitless evaluation announcing retaliation. Yeah. Frustrating enemy against rising. You can't conquer an enemy you don't understand. Fear has an enemy. Yeah. Its name is faith. Fill your faith with the word of God, and your fears will starve to death. If you have the fear of fear, then rest assured that your success is near. Because then you will begin to dare to try some things that are rare. See, it's time to change your gear, even though it's not New Year. Maybe your past was full of despair, but I urge you to forget where you were. I know stepping into the unknown can scare. Life may not always seem fair. There might be some pain to bear, but greater is he that is in you, I swear. No one said he won't shed another tear, but stay strong. God has done what he said. He is God. No one can compare. He created you, your mouth, your eyes, and ears. So when trouble is here, don't run like a deer. For God is right there. He knows you so well. He counts in your head. Oh, I feel it in the air. That dream you hope for is very near. But you must work hard to get there and must step out in faith and dare. In all that your conscience declare, whatever you get, learn to share. Let people see how much you care, even if you can hardly afford enough to wear.
Yeah.
Feel the fear, but step out in the middle of that fear. And after the wear and the tear, life will become sweeter than pear. F-E-A-R. So what's it going to be to you? Forget everything and run, or face everything and rise.